SWAT class is a very well-rounded killing machine capable of spraying all Zeds in a given area. So let's take a look at the SWAT starting equipment and weapons. The SWAT starts out with the MP7 submachine gun, the 9mm pistol, the tactical knife, and flashbangs. Looking at the MP7 first, the MP7 weighs 4 pounds and costs $200. The MP7 will do 16 damage per shot and can do an estimated 254 damage per second. The MP7 can fire in either full auto mode or in semi-auto mode. The MP7 is an excellent starting weapon as it provides good damage, a high rate of fire, and can make quick work of any small Zeds in the area as well as most medium Zeds. Moving on to the flashbangs, the flashbangs will do 125 damage on initial hit, as well as stun all enemies within that given area, provided that they are not raging at the moment. Flashbangs are probably one of the most useful grenades out of any of the classes, as it allows you to stun large targets like Skrikes and Fleshpounds, as well as stun large groups of enemies that may be giving your team trouble. Moving on to the knife and the 9mm pistol. Both the knife and 9mm pistol can be used quite effectively with the SWAT, as their level 10 perk, Close Combat Training, allows them to get bonus damage with both the knife and the 9mm pistol, making them fairly effective weapons in the early game. The first weapon that the SWAT can afford is the MP5 submachine gun. The MP5 weighs 4 pounds and costs $650. The MP5 does 25 damage per shot and can do roughly 373 damage per second. The MP5 can be fired in 3-round burst or in full auto. I don't find myself taking the MP5 all that often, simply because I don't find it much better than the MP7, and would just rather hold on to my cash to afford a better weapon. That being said, there's nothing wrong with the MP5. It's a completely competent weapon, capable of dealing with any small or medium Zed fairly quickly and fairly efficiently. The next weapon that the SWAT can afford is the Medic Submachine Gun, also known as the HM Tech 201 Submachine Gun. The Medic Submachine Gun weighs 3 pounds and costs $650. The Medic Submachine Gun does 15 damage per shot and 200 damage per second. It can be fired in full auto mode, and its secondary fire is its healing darts. Each healing dart costs 50% of its total charge rate, and each healing dart can heal 15 hit points. Despite the Medic Submachine Gun's low damage, it does provide a lot of utility for the team, allowing you to heal them from a distance. The next weapon we're going to be talking about for the SWAT is the P90. The P90 weighs 5 pounds and costs $1,100. The P90 does 30 damage per shot and can do 429 damage per second. It can be fired in either semi-auto mode or full auto mode. Overall, I do really like the P90, as you can shoot it very fast, very accurately, and with it having very minimal recoil, as well as its huge magazine capacity, allows you to spray for a long period of time without having to reload. The next weapon is the MAC-10. The MAC-10 weighs 4 pounds and costs $1,100. The MAC-10 does 25 damage on hit, as well as 18.5 fire damage on hit, and can do roughly 649 damage per second. The MAC-10 can be fired in either semi-auto or full auto. The MAC-10 is the most recently added weapon to the SWAT's arsenal, and is a welcome addition, as it allows you to have a lot of damage per second, as well as maintaining good accuracy, and it also comes with a second odd feature. Unlike all the other submachine guns, the MAC-10's bullets actually count as shotgun damage towards enemies, meaning that they'll do bonus damage towards enemies like Gore Fiends and Gore Fast that take bonus damage to shotguns. However, the MAC-10 will not get any bonuses from other classes like support that have shotgun-related skills. Next up is the UMP-45. The UMP weighs 5 pounds and costs $1,200. The UMP does 45 damage per shot and can do 450 damage per second. It can be fired in either full auto or burst fire. The UMP is the highest damaging submachine gun per shot, but does suffer from a lack of rate of fire compared to other submachine guns. Its sights can also be somewhat blocky, but overall I really like the UMP-45. I find it to be an exceptionally good weapon. And then the final weapon available to the SWAT is the Chris. The Chris weighs 6 pounds and costs $1,500. The Chris can do 33 damage per shot and 660 damage per second. It can be fired in either full auto or semi-auto. Overall, the Chris is definitely the best weapon that the SWAT has, as it allows you to have an extremely high rate of fire with extremely good accuracy, being able to put a lot of shots on target in a very short amount of time. So now that we've looked at the SWAT's weapons, let's look at their passive perks. The SWAT class gets perk weapon damage, 1% per level, up to 25% max, bullet resistance, 5% plus 1% per level, up to 30% max, increased magazine capacity, 4% per level, up to 100% max, and weapon switch speed, 1% per level, up to 25% max. Alright, moving on from that, we're going to be taking a look at some SWAT builds and loadouts. The first swap build is the one that I generally go with. Starting out with level 5, I start out with heavy armor training to get the bonus armor and then switch to tactical movement after the first round. At level 10, I start out using close combat training for the bonus damage with the knife and pistol, as well as starting out with that second pistol, and then immediately switch to tactical reload after 2 to 3 rounds. At 15, I go with suppression rounds to start with, but then switch to ammo vest once I can start holding more ammo. At 20, I start out with assault armor first, just to start out with that extra armor, and then switch to cripple to have more stopping power with the submachine guns. And then finally at 25, I go with rapid assault. With this build, it mostly helps with your gun's recoil, allowing your submachine guns to have very, very little recoil. This is best used in areas where you won't be moving around very much and where crouching is going to be your best bet. So if you're playing by yourself, this build generally isn't the best, but with teams in most positions, you can make this work very well. The second build is going for more of a tank build with SWAT. At level 5, taking heavy armor training for bonus armor and the ability to not be grabbed by small enemies like clots. At level 10, going close combat early just for the bonus pistol knife damage and that extra pistol that you get, and then switching to tactical reload shortly after that. At level 15, going with either suppression rounds or ammo vest. It's your choice, as both these choices are very good. At level 20, going with assault armor, allowing you to have even more armor. And then at 25, going with rapid assault. And then the final build for SWAT that I have here is more of a hybrid build. At level 5, going with either tactical movement or heavy armor training, depending on what you want. At level 10, starting out with close combat and then switching to tactical reload. At 15, your choice between suppressive rounds and ammo vest. At 20, going assault armor for the bonus armor. And then at 25, going rapid assault or battering ram. It's your choice. I would much rather go with rapid assault, though. With the hybrid build, it's more mix and match, but the SWAT class, really regardless of build, can function pretty much the same as a close to medium range, high damage per second class. Alright, so moving on to loadouts. I really only have two popular loadouts for SWAT, as most SWAT loadouts don't really seem to change all that much. The first loadout is going with the Chris submachine gun as your primary weapon, then going with either the UMP-45 or the P-90 as a secondary weapon, and then finishing the build off with the MAC-10. With this build, it allows you to do the most amount of damage and have the most amount of bullets that you can. It's your choice between the UMP and the P-90, as both these guns are very good. You can go with the P-90 if you wish to have more ammunition in the gun, as well as a higher rate of fire, or go with the UMP if you want more damage per shot. It's completely up to you. The second popular loadout for SWAT is going with the Chris submachine gun as your primary weapon, and then your choice between the UMP, the MAC-10, and the P-90, and then going with the Medic submachine gun as your final weapon. This loadout favors utility over damage compared to the other loadout, as then you can actively switch to the Medic submachine gun to heal teammates while still having high damage with the Chris, and then having some sort of secondary with either the UMP, the MAC-10, or the P-90 if you run out of bullets with the Chris. Alright, before we finish up, let's go over some SWAT tips. The first tip for SWAT is use your flashbangs against large groups of enemies and large Zeds. This will allow you and your team to more easily move around the map, as well as take down large enemies like Skrakes and Fleshpounds without them posing as much a threat to your team, as well as allowing you to deal with them by yourself fairly effectively. The second tip is aim for the head. Your guns have really high rates of fire, but they don't do a ton of damage, and your bullets do cost quite a bit. So aiming for the head will allow you to conserve bullets while still maintaining respectable amounts of damage towards any enemy. The third tip is remember to switch between your fire modes, especially if you're trying to conserve ammo. This can help out a lot during the early stages of a round, switching any of the submachine guns to the semi-auto, allowing you to conserve ammo early, and then switch to full auto, assuming that there's any medium or large Zeds that are coming, and allowing you not to run through your bullets quite as fast. The fourth tip is remember to start with the heavy armor training, the close combat training, and the assault armor perks, all to start with in the very first round, regardless of what build you're going for. With these, it allows you to start out with 100 armor and a second pistol, which can give you a huge advantage in the starting rounds and can transition quite well into the later rounds, as if you do not get hit, then you can maintain that bonus armor for quite a long time. And even if you don't intend on using the pistol, you can still sell it for the bonus 75 cash that it's worth. And then the fifth and final tip for SWAT is focus on the smaller Zeds before going for the bigger ones. Your class does exceptionally well at killing any of the small or medium Zeds fairly quickly, but can struggle against larger Zeds if you do not actively hammer away at weak points. So try to kill all the small and medium Zeds that are immediate threats to you while just baiting out the large enemies, until you can deal with them or until somebody on your team can deal with them effectively. And unless, of course, you are under attack by a large Zed, then do what you have to survive. So overall, the SWAT is probably one of the most user-friendly classes in the game. You can tear through waves of small Zeds in just a matter of seconds. With your flashbangs, you can deal with larger and medium Zeds without any trouble. And overall, this class is just pretty fun and pretty straightforward. Just pick up your gun, use your flashbangs when you need to, and then just spray any of the small Zeds down, and you should be golden with this class. So this brings me to the end of my SWAT guide. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Next time we're going to be taking a look at the Survivalist class. That one should be interesting. So I hope to see all of you guys there. And thank you guys so very much for watching this video. If you guys have been having a good day, keep on having a good day. If you guys have been having a bad day, well, I hope this video made your day just a little bit better. I hope to see all of you guys next time. Till then, stay cool and bye.